could come back over the hill and run over him.
The day is still young.
Enough food, Nancy?
You must be kidding. Whatever happened to hot dogs and potato salad?
Chrissy, how's the wine doing?
Feels ice cold, Mrs. Summerfield.
Well, I hope it's not too cold. Warren said it ruins the bouquet.
Mercy, mercy me. We wouldn't want to do that, would we?
Here they come.
Well, it wasn't a race.
It's always a race. Here, boss man, you look like a winner to me.
We seem to be missing our guest of honor.
There was another hill to climb.
Yeah, tell me about it. Really, tell me about it.
Well, the food is ready. Do you want to wait for sand?
We always wait for sand.
Well, I guess that settles it.
So how's it going?
Like slow poison. Maybe wives know how to play these games, but I can't.
So lay on the charm.
I did. I am. I will.
Well, it looks great, Nancy.
Thank Lila. Her party, not mine.
You always seem so tired when you come back from one of these rides.
Do I?
You know, you don't have to try to keep up.
With what?
With the others, you know.
Here comes Big Daddy.
Nancy.
I'm kidding. He's nothing.
Hey! Thought you guys were behind me.
You're a hard act to follow, Sam.
Anything to eat around here?
Yeah, jump in here. Find out for yourself.
Okay.
Hey. Watch yourself, ma'am. I'm right behind you. Don't forget to save me some goodies, huh?
I want Mr. Farragut.
Sunday afternoon with a client. He say any more about the Baja trip?
Mm-mm. But he will.
Okay. Here, Christy, you sit by me. Right here. That's the girl. Hey! Well, here we are. Good friends sharing good times and good food. But you want to know something? We're all dyed-in-the-wool ponies here.
We really are.
We buy ourselves these big chrome-plated bikes, and then we ride around on flat dirt like we're doing something big.
If this wasn't my day off, I might disagree with the client on that.
Oh, look around you, Warren. This country's nothing but one big parking lot. There's no bike to it. None to slow you down.
Well, we covered over 50 miles today, Sam.
How about 600 miles? All the way down Baja, Mexico.
Oh, come on, Sam.
Well, come on, Warren. What about all those mountains and desert and the big scenery you agency boys have been trying to shove down my throat?
Well, we're talking about an advertising campaign, not an expedition.
What's better than taking a look at what you're talking about, hmm?
Paul doesn't want to go. You can take me, Sam.
You got a deal, honey. Well, what do you say? You, me, Paul, Terry, we take a week off, straight down the middle of Baja, huh?
How about it, old buddy?
Who'll mind the store?
That a polite way of saying you don't want to go?
It's a polite way of saying I don't have the time.
Well, I guess everybody has to decide for himself what he thinks is important.
I thought this was a day off for the slave, Sam. Client or no client, you don't get your pound of flesh until Monday morning, 9 a.m.
We here at the Norlon Advertising Agency think that Baja itself will enhance the entire corporate image of Farragut Industries rather than just its heavy equipment division. Here it is, then, the total effect of what we hope to achieve. Farragut equipment will be thrust into the most punishing, unforgiving land to be found anywhere in the world. A match of brute strength between two giants, as we say in our copy, the final challenge.
I wish I could say it elevates me right out of this chair.
Would you be more specific?
You're the art director. What's your opinion?
Mr. Farragut, I'm going to have to go along with the agency position.
Go along? I thought you were supposed to be the maverick around here.
Yes, sir. I consider myself a creative individual.
Well, let's hear it. That outfit and that haircut don't look like agency position to me. I want some opinions around here, and I want some opinions that don't sound like they all come out of the same mouth.
Well, I've cooked up a few sample ideas.
I'm not interested in typefaces and graphic treatments or any of that agency garbage. I want something that makes me sit up and look twice. And I'm still waiting for that to happen.
You still don't seem to be very specific about your objections to the campaign.
How specific would you like? I think it lacks something. I think it needs work. I think it stinks.
Excuse me. Bergman. Yes, he is. Yes, I will. Excuse me, Mr. Farragut. Warren, Mr. Norland would like to see you.
Now?
He says it's important.
Excuse me, gentlemen, I have to leave.
Leave? We're just getting started.
Paul can take over. He knows the details of the campaign as well as I do.
I guess we're going to have a chance to find that out.
Boys upstairs in accounting. Seems we always end up dancing to their music, no matter what.
Mm, so it seems.
It's been 3 months since we discussed your termination, Warren, and they've been giving me a little pressure about the corporate credit cards.
Yes, of course. I'll turn them in immediately.
I've talked them into letting you keep the country club membership.
Thank you.
Until you get situated with something else. How long do you think that might be?
The Pritchard situation seems very promising. We should finalize this week.
I'm very pleased to hear that. The reason I took you out of the meeting is I want to make sure that you understand that the account group must remain unaware of a little transition. I know I can depend upon the fact that the Farragut account will continue to run smoothly during this tentative period. Of necessity, that has a very strong bearing on our arrangement, your continued status with the agency.
I understand.
Oh, by the way, Warren, you really ought to get rid of those suits. Those little narrow lapels went out with the gray flannels.
Pritchard likes to think of themselves as a now agency. You gotta get with it. You know what I mean. Meeting over?
Well, it's almost time for lunch, so we thought we'd break early and wait for you.
Tell him the deal we made, Paul.
Deal?
Oh, Sam drives a hard bargain. Almost as hard as he drives that bike of his,
right? Tell him.
He'll approve the campaign. As long as he can go down to Baja and personally choose the scenery we'll use for the ads.
You can't expect the poor client to make a trip like that all by himself.
I don't know what to expect.
Paul's gonna go, and so is Terry.
Well, we talked about it.
Man, I can dig it. Everybody else can.
I'm sorry, I still don't have the time.
I guess nobody understands around here.
Understands what?
The Farragut advertising account is not a contract stuffed away in a vault somewhere. It's me, old buddy. I'm the Farragut account.
Well, at least we can agree on one thing anyway.
Good, good. Now, the way I see it,
You boys are trying to sell a $1 million campaign to an old country boy like me. You're going to have to sell it. Now, let's both think real hard about how we can do that.
Wait. Children? Silence.
One of these days, the girls are actually going to get to school on time.
Maybe we should consider public school. Then you wouldn't have to drive so far.
Oh, Warren, you know we couldn't do that. They've got all their friends where they are. Warren, why did you make an appointment with Dr. Harris?
Someone's been looking through my desk.
I'm worried about you, and if that means looking through your desk, I'm going to do it.
My own private guardian angel.
My appointment with Dr. Harris is nothing but my annual checkup.
Are you sure?
Sure.
Warren? We never seem to have any time for each other. See what I mean?
I'll call you if I'm going to be late.
You promised we could redecorate the living room. You remember, I showed you that alfresco effect in the magazine.
How much?
Well, I don't know. I won't know until he gives me an estimate. Can I call him?
Yes, call him.
So what do you think?
I think it's beautiful. Terry, could we meet and have lunch today?
Farragut can dig it, man. All I gotta do is lay it on him at the right time. He's gonna buy the whole package. Warren and Paul, they're fighting it, but no way. They're just a pair of suits, cruise directors. Sam knows I'm the creator, the main man. All starts with me.
I thought maybe you could take the afternoon off like you used to, and we could get some wine and go to the beach.
Not today.
Sam Farragut would like to take me to the beach.
I noticed.
Yes, I noticed you noticed. That's all you did notice.
No time for this scene, Chrissy, no time.
You want me to move out?
Hey, that's your best shot. Don't waste it.
No, I have a better one. You want to hear it? I'm pregnant.
What?
Just a simple yes or no. You want me to keep it?
Wasting my time, Warren.
Do I get a good report?
What's all this business about a $200,000 policy?
Just thinking about it.
Doctor, there's a call for Mr. Summerfield on 2.
It'll be in my office. I told him I was here. I expected an important message. Thank you.
See me before you go.
Hello? Linda? Did Mr. Pritchett call? His secretary? Did you make an appointment? But he must have left a message. Linda, he wouldn't have gone to Europe without leaving a message. That me?
Mm-hmm. Get your message?
Yes, I got him.
Looks good.
see any reason why I couldn't take a trip.
Where?
To Bahia. On a motorcycle.
Look, Warren, you may be in pretty good physical shape, but you're still not a kid.
That's what you said when I bought the bike.
You didn't listen to me then, either.
About that policy, why don't you put through the report on it?
It seems to me about 3 years ago, we certified you for $100,000.
Progress, the mark of a successful executive.
Not so pretty on the inside, are we?
Paul?
Mm-hmm.
You really going on that Baja trip?
Farragut's the client. Assistant account execs don't get votes.
If you did get a vote, would you still go?
Nancy, you know I'm in a transitional period of the agency. They're grooming me, setting me up for more responsibility. That means a promotion and more money. It's a chance to do the things we used to talk about. Is that what you want?
Is it really important what I want?
Yes, it is important what you want.
And what I want is the man I married.
The man you married lived in an apartment with one closet, and somehow I don't think you'd be able to get all your clothes in.
Then I'll get rid of the clothes.
Why don't I believe you?
Why can't we go away, just us, to Carmel or someplace, 3 or 4 days, a weekend? If you can go on a motorcycle to Baja, why can't we...
Come on, Nancy, stop it. Carmel or across the street, it doesn't help. We carry the same routine with us wherever we are. Right? I gotta go to work.
It's been grand.
I told you, when Warren got me on that Farragut account, it wasn't going to be easy.
Farragut isn't an account. It's a way of life. Hi, it's me. You know, Paul's really going on that stupid motorcycle trip you've all been talking about? He'd even go alone if he had to, just to spite me. You know what that means? That I'll be here alone for at least a week. That's marvelous. We finally get a chance to be alone together, but you'd still rather run off to Baja with the boys. But it did happen.
It was a mistake. All I can do now is feel sorry for what we did to Paul and Lila.
Look, it was a bad time to call.
Nancy, I've been fired. I've lost my job. Lila doesn't even know about it.
You're busy. We'll talk later, okay? But not on the phone.
It doesn't matter. It's not like we were ever really part of each other's lives. This trip to Baja, it'll make things easier for everyone.
Hey, guys, have a made special just for us. Barry, this one's yours.
Hey, far out, look at this.
See. Oh, yeah, Warren. There you are. Same size as me.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm always into Mexico, man. How did you find this one?
Helps us get close to the action in a hurry.
Mm-hmm. Hey, listen, while I'm gone, why don't you call some people and throw a party?
A party needs a reason.
Don't get heavy again.
We haven't settled anything about the baby.
Listen, I can't think about it now. We'll work it out when I get back, okay?
This isn't like you at all.
What is?
Oh, changing your mind at the last minute, going to Baja to begin with. It's just not like you, Warren.
Maybe I've been predictable too long.
Since you believe in separate vacations, I think I'll take mine when you get back.
We can't solve the problem this way, Nancy.
Get it together, lover. We can't solve the problem, period.
Hey, not bad. Not bad. Thomas, get the camera. Let's have a picture of the four Wildcats. Paul!
What's this?
So we can tell you from the tourists. Let's get together for a picture.
What about the women?
Terry.
No, thanks. I never pose at stag parties.
Come on, Paul. Right here by my bike. Come on. There we are. Go ahead, Thomas.
Do we smile, or is this one guts?
Pray for the Wildcats.
Sidewalk ends.
Just for us. It gets better. Come on now, Pop, for drinks.
Boys, go ahead.
What's wrong?
Trying to free up the cable connection to the throttle.
It's sticky?
Something is. Engine locked wide open a couple of times.
That could be dangerous.
I'll fix it.
Yeah, I sure hope so. We don't need trouble where we're going.
Let's go.
Let's go!
Let me move!
Let me move!
You want
to hear me?
Sit!
You want
him?
Everybody knows.
Wait! Come on!
You don't want him to ruin our trip. We came down here to see Baja, didn't we? Come on, Sam. Let's have a good old time. Huh? That's what it's all about, okay?
Yeah, that's what it's all about.
Anybody not having a good old time? Paul, can I have a good old time?
Yeah, let's tear up, Sam. Let's tear him up.
Yeah, let's tear him up. That's what I like about you, old buddy. Always ready to pour a little oil on the wheels.
Ha! Ha! Ha!
That's four double shots of tequila.
He'll sweat it out.
Warren? I've been wondering why you had changed your mind.
About what?
About taking a trip. Coming down here.
Found my time to go, that's all.
Warren, I haven't really been straight with you. I know about what happened at the agency. I know about your talk with Norland.
Oh.
What is it? Is it pressure from Farragut?
Probably. Norland calls it a necessary executive realignment.
You're still the boss.
I've never felt that way with you, Paul.
She's awfully young.
I don't think Sam has any age limits.
Great start, huh?
Warren's been going through one of his moody cycles again. You know, I really thought this trip would be good for him. You know, give him a chance to unwind.
Paul never talks about what happens with them at the agency.
Really?
Even if he was fired, I probably wouldn't hear about it.
Well, it's a rule in our family. Warren and I always talk out any major problem. I mean, there's nothing held back, no secrets.
Everybody ought to have a few secrets, even husband.
Oh, talking things out. It's always better.
Lila, you're a rock.
Well, there are times I don't feel like it. Especially when Warren brings home that office personality of his. Nancy, you are not going to believe this. Do you know what Warren did to me the very day before he left? He made me sit down and listen to him read his will. Every word of it. I almost cried.
His will?
Yeah. I mean, can you imagine it? Going over a will like he was reading a stock market report or something. Well, it was the worst thing I ever had to do, just sit there as though nothing were wrong, as if people talked about dying all the time. And Warren, he made it sound like any other family discussion. Every detail. How his estate would be handled, the trust fund for the girls, the money that I'd get.
It's not like we were ever really part of each other's lives. This trip to Baja, it'll make things easier for everyone.
I've let Warren take over all the money responsibilities for the family, but he's so dependable, I never have to worry. All I have to do is sit there and listen to speeches and nod my head like a good little girl. It's a game we play. But I always remind myself, Warren only wants to make things easier for me.
This trip to Baja, it'll make things easier for everyone. It'll make things easier for everyone. Easier for everyone. Easier for everyone.
It's been 3 months since we discussed your termination, Warren, and they've been giving me a little pressure on the corporate credit cards.
Oh, yes, of course. I'll turn them in immediately.
I talked them into letting you keep the country club membership until you get situated with something else. How long do you think that might be?
The Pritchard situation seems very promising. We should finalize this week.
Very pleased to hear that.
What's all this business about a $200,000 policy?
Just thinking about it. Do you see any reason why I couldn't take a trip?
Where?
Baja. On a motorcycle.
That's what I call real scenery.
Let's go, Sam.
We can take a vote on that.
Come on, we came to see Baja, right? Champ.
Unreal, man. Unreal. Man, this whole country, it's just unreal.
Got the ride through Beverly Hills, Terry?
Yeah, I tell you, I wasn't expecting this.
Yeah. Hey, Warren. What was that fancy slogan you were trying to sell me?
The final challenge?
Yeah, the final challenge. I'm beginning to think it fits.
Is that a formal client approval, sir?
You wouldn't want it that easy.
Well, the closest I can figure, we're still 100 miles from where the highway to La Paz begins.
That's not bad for city boys.
We're not there yet.
Oh. A couple days we will be. Yeah. A couple days we will be. Should have stayed down by the coast.
The road turned inland.
What road? You mean that rut we've been riding along?
Be a lot cooler down by the ocean. I gotta ride my bike over to that mountain over there.
If I get up high enough, I'll probably be able to see the best way to go. I thought we agreed, Sam. No solo trips. We all stick together, right?
The rabbit run. Paul has a point, Sam.
Wanna go with me, old buddy? No scenic tours.
You boys just relax. I'll be back in time for supper.
Hey, maybe I'll go with you.
Thought you were caved in.
I am.
Better stay here, then.
I don't want to miss anything.
Terry's really hustling to pick up points.
Target doesn't give points. It only takes them away. One at a time.
Just a friendly visit, boy. Truth is, I came to apologize to you about that little trouble we had back at the cantina. I'm ashamed of myself. Too much tequila, I guess. I was telling my friend, I'll have to go back and make amends. Do something right for a change.
No big thing.
Shake on that?
Peace.
That's nice. That's mighty nice. Well, I bet you and your girl are having a mighty good time off by yourselves this way.
Yeah, we are.
Looks like you could use a little help, though. A little money or something to get you home safe.
No thanks, we're okay.
Sure would make me feel better. I can tell you're running pretty close to the bone. Just a few extra bucks to buy some gas. The thing looks like it drinks the stuff.
For sure.
How's $100 feel to you?
Are you putting me on?
No, it's all yours.
Wait a minute. Nobody gives away bread for nothing.
Well, if it'd make you feel better, maybe you could give me something back. How's that?
Get out of here.
Hey, Sam, let's roll.
Just having a friendly little discussion, Terry.
Won't be the same as it was back at the cantina.
I understand you hippies. That's because I'm a kind of a hippie myself. I'm a hippie with money. No old-fashioned rules about what's right and wrong. Just hang loose and let it all happen. Ain't that right? Take your girlfriend down there on the beach. She probably feels the same way. This week down here with you, next week somewhere else with somebody else. What difference does it all make?
Come on, Sam.
Shut up!
You are twisted, man.
I'm easy to get along with, boy. How many $100 bills is it going to take to do business with you? Two or three?
Get out of here. Just get out of here.
Come on. Come on, hippie. Come on, hippie.
You crazy or something?
Come on, hippie. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, hippie.
Hey, come Sam, on. Come on.
Get away from me, you lousy freak.
Come on, hippie. Hey. Come on. Come on. He just bought himself a long walk home.
To go the rest of this trip on foot.
I'm worried about you.
Came from the north. What happened?
From the north?
Yes, you were heading west towards the mountains.
Well, it looks like we're going to have to tell them the truth. Huh, Terry? We got lost. We got lost. Plain lost. Isn't that right, Terry?
Yeah, that's right, yeah. We got lost. I mean, it doesn't matter anyway, does it?
I've told you all I know. He's somewhere in Baja on a motorcycle trip with three other men. They've been gone 3 days now. I am trying to save a man's life. He might already be dead.
You must realize that a land and air search of Baja would be a considerable undertaking. We are prepared to ask the Mexican government to do this, of course, providing we can be absolutely certain that our request is justified and
that we have exercised prudent and careful judgment. Regretfully, I would have to discuss this matter with some member of the immediate family before I could
initiate any request to Mexico City. Perhaps if the man's wife were to call.
Someone who might have a more personal knowledge of the situation.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Buenas tardes, señores. Captain Gutierrez, Federale de Mexico. I will need to have your visitor permit. Por favor.
Oh, well, I guess we better give the man what he wants. It's his country.
Maxim? Very good. Summerfield? McElvain. Now keep these.
Excuse me, Captain. They told us we had to turn in those permits back at the border.
I'll keep them until they're verified, senor. A formality. Palmas Bonitas is beyond the next hill. You were planning to stop there?
No.
Plan to.
Simple yes or no. You want me to keep it?
He just bought himself a long walk home.
I get the idea you don't greet all the tourists in the middle of the desert like this, Captain.
We're investigating an accident. Americanos. A young man and woman. You might have passed them on the beach below San Felipe. They were traveling in a kind of van.
Sounds like you're talking about the two hippies.
We passed their camp a few days ago. What happened?
This morning we found the man about 5 kilometers from his camp. He was dead. Exhaustion, exposure, heat of the sun. Hard to say.
What about the girl?
She was found crawling in the hills. Snake bite in her leg. She's still alive now, but who can be sure?
We didn't even stop to talk to her.
Ah, but there were motorcycle tracks around the van.
Couldn't have been us. Like the man said, we didn't even stop to say hello. Hey, what time we passed that hippie camp? It was about noon, wasn't it?
I don't know.
Had to be about then. Boy, those two hippies were sure having a high old time.
A high old time, senor?
Oh, yeah. They was really having some fun. Grabbing at one another like monkeys. Both of them, stark naked. Stark naked, right on the beach.
You want to know what I think? I think those two were stoned out on drugs. Most hippies usually are, you know.
Perhaps that could explain the radiator.
Radiator?
Yes, it was open with a hatchet, like somebody wanted to kill it.
Sounds like they're dropping acid to me.
That doesn't make sense, Terry.
Never been on acid.
Dang gone, that's a shame. I guess we'll never find out what happened unless the woman lives, and you say there's a chance she might.
Quien sabe. But for the moment, enjoy yourselves in Palmas Bonitas. Rest? Forget about it. Tomorrow will come soon enough. We'll know then.
Well, if you're going to be around later, the drinks are on me.
Don't worry. I'll be around.
Let's go.
Come on, let's go.
he must have been put together with steel rivets.
One of the nicest guys in the world.
You know, I've been thinking about those kids on the beach.
Acid heads.
You know, I was going to try that one time. Acid.
Come on.
No, really.
Huh?
Well, I'm 44. It's time to try everything. At least once. Would acid make them disable their van?
Why not?
Anybody want another beer?
Yeah.
You lied, didn't you? When you and Farragut took off together, you went over to the kids' camp.
What are you talking about?
I'd like to know that myself. What?
It's part of the payment plan. You play Sam's game, you gotta back him up.
It's the heat. It's gotta be.
Everything he says, everything he does, you back him up.
Hey, man.
He's like acid.
He makes people do anything.
It was just like Sam said. Nothing happened. Nothing. Tell me, did you try and stop him? Did you really try?
Whatever he says, whatever he does.
And I just don't believe all this. All right, Warren. What are we gonna do?
It's very simple. Either he tells the captain, or we do.
It's definitely a choice between Aztec maize and Imperial gold.
Well, that narrows it down.
Oh, Lulu, could you get the wallpaper, too?
Thanks.
Juan will be coming home on Saturday. I've got to get this mess cleaned up before then, so he doesn't have to get involved in all this.
Does he ever get involved?
He really hates it when the house is torn up like this. Man's castle, all that stuff.
Lila.
Ugh, that's awful.
Lila. Lila. I'm having a thing with Warren. Did you hear what I said?
Sunset beige. Sunset beige is not bad.
I just said something to you.
It's not bad with the chairs.
I'm having
a thing with Warren. Of course, I'll have to completely redo the carpeting. Yes, I know. I've known for some time, Nancy.
You've known and you've let it go on? Well, nothing like the little tea time discussion to bring it out in the open.
Are you sure you really want this discussion?
Well, don't act so civilized.
Well, what do you want me to do? You want me to scream at you? You want me to get a gun and shoot you?
Warren has lost his job.
Warren's been with the agency 15 years.
Lila, do you know what he has gone to do? He has gone down to Baja to kill himself. When you told me he read his will, that's how I knew. He has gone to commit suicide.
What are you talking about?
There's a man in the federal building downtown, Mr. Perrins. Now, he can get the Mexican government to find him and bring him back before it's too late, but the request has to come from a member of his family.
Nancy!
Go ahead. Say it.
I think I know Warren better than you do, Nancy. I think he wouldn't kill himself. I think he's not that kind of man.
Make it sunset beige. That's the real you, restrained and gentle.
Ladies and gentlemen, now this little number here is called a Boilermaker. Boilermaker. Comprende?
Boilermaker.
You're supposed to make it with bourbon, but we ain't got no good old bourbon, so this tequila you boys drink.
Well,
tequila, well, that ought to do just fine. Ought to give it a nice little kick.
That's right, a good old kick in the teeth. How's Sam?
That's right, old buddy. Now, watch what happens. Don't get...
Trouble.
Olé. Olé. Olé.
the coming of age, man. Hey, did I tell you guys I am getting married? Hey, Sam, did I tell you, man, I'm getting married?
Captain, here we go, Captain.
I mean, it's about time, right? You give me a blank sheet of paper, man, and I can make it all happen.
Wait a minute. Hey.
All I gotta do is get the rest of my life straight. Buy me some kids. And start towards getting a little piece of that American dream.
I've got your piece already. It's just like we could have figured. No way is Terry going to say anything.
He's drunk.
Every man to his own way out.
I've got a better way out.
Come on, wait a minute. Let's talk about it. Come on. Give me a few minutes.
There you go. How'd you go? How'd you go?
You ever think about giving all this up?
Giving what up?
The agency business. The rat race, all the little sellouts back in there.
Little?
Big. Really big. Where do we go from here, Warren? Where do nice-looking, aging boys with good taste go?
Tell me. Where?
I don't know.
Warren.
Listen to me. I know you want to go to the captain on this thing. You're right. You are right. But what you've got to understand is it's not like back home. They can put you in jail for a traffic accident.
We're not talking about traffic accidents.
Well, why are we pushing? When that girl comes out of it, the bomb is going to go off anyway. Look, if we can just get back to civilization, then we can go to the police. Go to the American consulate. We tell them everything we know. Then, it's out of our hands.
That's it, isn't it? Our world. Whatever happens, just make sure that it's out of our hands.
You know, we never have a chance to talk anymore. I kind of miss that. Warren, listen. I know this situation at the agency has got you uptight. I know this has got you uptight, but there's something else, because you're not yourself.
What does that mean? There is no myself.
An actor.
Man of a thousand faces. One for Farragut, one for Norlin, one for Lila, one for the children, one... Not myself anymore. There's nothing in the mirror.
Warren, you want Lila to have to come down here and try and get you out of jail?
No, I don't want Lila to come down here.
All right. Then go along with me on this. Huh? Cool it till we get back.
Then, as soon as you get back across the border, you'll tell the police. You swear it, Paul.
Me? Us. We both go to the police. Huh? Right, old buddy?
Right, old buddy.
Okay. I'm going back to the hotel. You want to go on? You know, I just thought it hadn't been for all this. Tomorrow would have been the last day of the big Baja jump.
The last day.
Come
going on?
It's over, Warren. The girl died last night.
What do you mean it's over?
Nobody to testify, man. The captain gave us our permits back. It's over. Farragut and Terry are off to La Paz. They got a plane now.
Why didn't you come and get me?
I started to, Warren, but I found my bike is broken. I think a piston seized or something. Look, I made a command decision. I mean, I'm stuck here anyway. Why not let him go on? It's a boat for Wyman's this afternoon. We can catch it and get out of here. So what if we leave the bikes behind? I never liked that Sunday afternoon gentleman bikers jazz.
So we go back by ourselves. And we're all off the hook. Right? No police, no statement.
The girl's dead, Warren. That changes things.
No, it doesn't.
What the hell do we really know anyway? Terry's the one that's got to make a statement. Look, it's out of our hands. If you want to go, you go. I'm out of it. I'm out of it!
Paul.
Paul!
Do you remember what we talked about last night?
We talked about a lot of things.
No, I mean about Terry. You said he got drunk because that's the way he found his way out.
Something like that.
How much sugar did you have to put in your gas tank to find your way out?
What are you going to do?
Just once. I want to get the world back into my own hands.
We both don't have to go down the tubes.
We already have.
You've got nothing to lose! Everybody knows you had your chance and you blew it! It's my chance now! I can have every count if I keep Farragut happy! You've got nothing to lose!
Sam, not this time.
Do what, old buddy?
We're going back to find the captain. Terry's got something to tell him.
Tell him what?
Oh, of course you couldn't have heard. Terry and I had a little talk last night. He doesn't work for the agency anymore. Now he works directly for Farragut Industries. He's my new advertising manager.
Oh, congratulations. Now let's go back.
Even if we find the captain, man, he's not going to listen to me.
Let's give him a chance.
You are making this seem like it's all my fault.
No, Terry. We all share this one. You, me, Paul. We all get to wallow in the mud.
Terry, maybe you better go on back to Palmas Bonitas. I think Warren and I have a few things to straighten out. Go.
Got your back up, don't you? Think you know something.
Sam, you killed those kids just as surely as if you used the hatchet on them instead of the van.
Now, if I were to speak to Norlon when I get back, tell him how unhappy I'd be if the agency fired you.
Price comes the liar.
I figured it might. That's the way it is with a man like you. You live by the rules, and you die by the rules.
You know Terry ain't gonna say anything to the captain. Unless you're standing right there over.
Don't threaten me, Sam.
I don't have to threaten you. You're finished already. See, I know about the job at the Pritchard Agency that you didn't get. I know about the boats you're trying to sell to pay your debts. About the $200,000 insurance policy.
Anything else?
About the phony trouble with the sticky throttle. Make us think you might have an accident. You're a suicide package ready-made, Warren. Just looking for some place to happen.
You killed those kids, Sam.
I never got the living room painted.
That's because you were waiting for me to help.
Hello. You still want a separate vacation?
No. I want a divorce.
I don't think you'll have to leave your agency now if you don't want to.
I know. Does it worry you, Paul? Whether or not I leave the agency?
No. It doesn't worry me.
The names will be different. And the styles will be different, but the wars will be the same.
What are you talking about?
The Sam Farraguts of the world, that's what I'm talking about. And they're all yours, old buddy. And God help you.
Man, I could have gone first class with Farragut.
I'm sorry.
Hey, you know, I've been thinking about it. The baby? If you want to keep it, okay.
There isn't any baby. Not anymore.
were the pampered wives of wealthy men, each one young and beautiful, and looking for excitement. But an afternoon shopping spree yielded more than they bargained for.
Driver, why are we stopping here?
When suddenly, they were snatched. Now, $3 million is the price in their lives, and 36 hours all the time they have left, if they can make it.
You do have your insulin with you, don't you? I just thought we were going to be gone a couple of hours. My God.
Surely their husbands will pay.
What about the ransom money?
Well, we're going to pay, of course, but how do you raise $3 million by tomorrow?
Can I arrange a commercial loan?
Unless they have reason not to.
I just talked to one of your husbands. I don't know which one. The point is, he said he wasn't going to pay.
From executive producers Aaron Spelling and Leonard Goldberg, a suspenseful story of romance, ransom, and revenge, as riveting as today's headlines.
All these hijackings, these ransoms, all this lunacy.
Robert Reed and Anthony Zerbe, Sherry North, Leslie Nielsen, Barbara Parkins, John Saxon, Tisha Sterling, Howard Duff. Three hostages locked in a nightmare. Three husbands blackmailed into terror. Six lives running out of time. Snatched from Republic Pictures Home Video.